This is a geranium, one of the most popular bedding plants grown in greenhouses nationwide, along with a number of other annuals and perennials. People enjoy having these and many other plants because of the effect they have on our well-being. Plants are more than a luxury, they're necessities in our environment.
My name is Rosa Rabdales. I am an associate professor and extension specialist at the University of Connecticut. And I work doing research in water quality and doing outreach with greenhouse growers where we cover several technical aspects of growing.
Traditional farming is becoming increasingly difficult due to the environmental impacts of climate change, such as soil degradation, unpredictable weather patterns, and an increased need for irrigation. This makes greenhouse incredibly beneficial in winter seasons and geographical regions in the world where it would be too resource intensive or impossible to cultivate crops. Our state ranks 15th nationwide and responsible for 1/3 of all agricultural sales in the state. There are opportunities to further increase the impact of the greenhouse industry in Connecticut and beyond. But the greenhouse industry faces its own challenges that are making it difficult for the industry to reach its full potential. UConn Extension works with greenhouses in Connecticut by providing educational outreach on technology, sustainability, water quality, and integrated pest management practices.
And I've told this story so many times, but we had like 10 flats left over. And so we went to the local hardware store and we sold those 10 flats of tomatoes for $3 a flat. We made $30. We thought we were the richest people in Canterbury.
Joyce and Dave Hart own and operate Hart's Greenhouse and Florist. Both graduated from UConn's College of Agriculture, Health, and Natural Resources. Over the course of 37 years in business and running their four locations in Eastern Connecticut, they have adopted many technologies and innovative practices that have contributed to their success and growth.
We put in about a half an acre of flooded floor, which is 16 zones in our particular floor. They're 12 feet wide by 100 feet long, and there's holes drilled down the middle in the concrete as the slightest little pitch to it, and 20,000 gallons of storage water, different fertilizer blends, and we program that on a computer of what zones we want to water. Our disease problems are very, very little because we're not overhead watering where foliage is getting wet. All the water is reused, recycled. We don't waste any water whatsoever.
A lot of drip lines, drip tape to keep our water use down. So we actually use quite a few transplanting machines.
We can do about 400 flats.
400 flats an
hour. With that machine, where when we used to transplant by hand, our best transplanter, if she was having a good day, could do about 12 flats an hour. This industry really, really needs qualified workers. We were very, very close to buying two other retail garden centers in Connecticut that would have been super spots. And we were really interested in it, but we had to say no to both of them just because we were afraid we couldn't staff them, which is unfortunate. We're constantly looking for growers. If we had five growers come to us tomorrow that were qualified, we'd hire every one of them. That's about our biggest concern right now.
We wholesale what we retail. Our wholesale and retail are about 50-50, but I think in years to come, the wholesale end of our business will be increasing. Wholesale business really are, there is no limit, just the limit is how far we want to drive with our plants. We have people come in almost daily looking for pollinator plants. Once they start having some plants in their own yard, because they hear about it, you know, like, oh, I should plant pollinator plants, I save the bees. Like, it's a big movement, and all of these ornamentals will draw insects into your yard, butterflies, hummingbirds. It just brings a lot of happiness, and, you know, I think people in general feel better when they're around more plants, and it benefits the whole planet.
You've always leaned on UConn, and you've always been incredibly responsive.
I spend a lot of my time with one-on-one grower visits to help educate the industry so that they can continue promoting these sustainable practices. And I work more so with sustainable practices in terms of pest and disease management.
Leanne held our hand for a lot of years. She's pretty much taught us everything we need to know, and which was a huge help to us.
Pest management is really challenging, and even though it's a controlled environment inside, pests or diseases can be inadvertently introduced as the young transplants or cuttings come in. So there have been a lot of exciting innovations in terms of types of natural enemies that are available and how they are delivered and introduced into the crops, biologically based fungicides that are now available, microbial based insecticides, insect killing beneficial nematodes. If they are using pesticides, they're using much fewer pesticides and they're much safer. More of the growers are using biological controls, and this makes the greenhouse environment a much safer environment than it was, for instance, 30 or 40 years ago.
Grower Direct Farms in Summers is the largest greenhouse business in Connecticut, with over 40 acres of environmentally controlled greenhouses. The family company wholesales all their products to retail outlets throughout the Northeast. Adam Van Wingerden and Sam Smith are two owners of Grower Direct Farms.
So here at our main facility, we're roughly 40 acres, and how we break that up for bedding plants in the springtime, our garden mums and our poinsettias, we break them down into zones, and roughly for us, a zone is about an acre. Sometimes we'll consolidate and make larger zones. Behind us is one of the larger zones that we have. We are as precise as we can in our environmental control system, and it's given us temperature, humidity, and that's giving feedback to the control system that allows it to create ventilation. So, you know, we're defining what we think is an optimum environment for our crop, and that control system is operating the ventilation, heat, irrigation, and so we're creating the set points and the computer is doing it for us, so we're not manually going out to open a vent. And as it measures those data points constantly, it will adjust and either close the window or open it more to make sure that we're getting that precise control we want on our crops.
We become an access point for technologies. So our reach is global, even though everything that we produce here is grown and consumed locally. So we reach out to other places where there's agricultural innovation happening, and we import those processes and technologies and they get developed. And then often those ideas are then shared with the producers around us. We become an incubator for new technologies and ideas that can improve the efficiency of all the farms in Connecticut.
So we were able to work with the states and utilize some land that wasn't really conducive to greenhouses or farming, and able to put up solar system. And we were able to reduce about half to two-thirds of our production and put that into solar. We utilize energy curtains. You know, people think of them as a blanket. So in the morning, those curtains are able to retract and allow the light and the natural warmth that the sun creates inside of our greenhouse. At night, those curtains close and it helps keep the energy that was created inside the greenhouse. And it also shrinks the amount of space that we have to heat and just focusing on the area beneath that energy blanket.
One of the most exciting things that I'm watching them develop is a computer-controlled irrigation system. And so today, we irrigate with a high degree of precision, but it still requires human decisions. And so the next iteration of that is having moisture meters in the plants themselves, which communicate to a computer and then uses an algorithm to make computer-based choice for us, which will give us an even higher degree of precision about how we use water. Most of the technology that we're working on is aimed at labor efficiency and product quality improvement. Our industry has widespread problems recruiting and retaining talent at leadership level and at the labor level too.
I've got three UConn grads in our, you know, growing department, technical experts in, you know, the growing of our plants. They're critical to our long-term success. We need specialists and experts in facility maintenance, data analysis, and replenishment. You know, when working with our customers, we're looking at what is scanning and selling, and then we're resupplying based on what people are taking out of their store. Engineers, you know, people that are making these things, we need people that can run them and also know how they work.
One of our reoccurring challenges is helping regulators, legislators, and consumers understand what we are and what our value is to the community. I'd like to see political leadership get invested in understanding this part of Connecticut agriculture, on what these greenhouses can do for us economically, and I think for our collective community health too. It's extremely valuable today, and it has the potential to be integral to the success of us as a community in the future. Our partnership with UConn has been incredibly valuable to that. It gives us access to expertise and a platform to share our message about our value to the collective agricultural economy and then just Connecticut in general. So, you know, we'd want people to know, you know, we're sustainably producing live plants that are great for the overall both physical and mental health of everybody that lives here in Connecticut.
This is an industry seeking individuals with diverse expertise in horticulture, integrated pest management, infrastructure, engineering, coding, computers, social sciences, and social media marketing. People with diverse interests and expertise can find an opportunity in the greenhouse industry. The greenhouse industry continues to push forward in reshaping the way we cultivate our crops. The industry supports growers, business owners, resellers such as your local store, to share these beautiful pieces of nature in our communities, and will continue to play a pivotal role in Connecticut and the world.